In 2016, Gabriel Stewart decided to walk 1,000 miles round the United Kingdom from his house in Hackney. I joined him to document part of his journey from Ipswich in Suffolk to Norwich in Norfolk, the home of his beloved football team, Norwich City FC. It all started when I was sitting on the train. Looking out, I decided I wanted to be out there. The open expanse of countryside where you can see everything for miles. Barely any civilization. Having no responsibilities. I decided to walk because home is boring. Boring as shit. I was stuck at home, sitting on my sofa or the bed, with the impact of my bum permanently imprinted on both of them by now. I'd tap away at the computer, pointlessly pretending that watching or reading articles or the news gives myself some sort of importance. I've lived in London all my life.
Over the road, the chap over the road I know, Bob his name is.
Yeah.
If you ask him his name is Bob, he got a caravan, mobile home, just the other side of the road.
Okay.
The old boy next door is a bit of a twat. We live in a four-bedroom house.
Yeah.
But the chap over the road is a nice chap. They got a couple of tractors and lorries out there. If you want some water or anything, he'd help you out.
Okay. Oh, that sounds good. Good.
All right.
Thank you so much.
There's a nice spot actually, because there's always a
follow the train lines, find footpaths and roads which take me away from the sat-nav's fastest route. Google Maps, then OS Maps, plan the route out. Walking from the city to the countryside, the buildings slowly slip away. Momentarily, you're in scummy suburbia. You know you've walked from somewhere. Walking lets me be a part of the landscape. You notice the hidden away things that are kept tucked away from the tourists. You are the fly on the wall, and you experience everything. Pain, hunger, loss, and intense freedom. Miles and miles from the late teenage drink-fueled backpacking barley binges. The searing pain of my ankle reemerges. It reminds me of what a twat I was for committing to walk 1,000 miles in a year. You know you need to stop when your feet are absolutely sodden at 9 in the morning, and you can feel them slowly disintegrating.
When I see feet like that, I kind of think I've given up before now.
Yeah, I would understand that.
Yeah. On the other hand, I'm on my feet all day, every day.
Yeah.
My stuff got soaked the next day when we carried on walking during the storm. But then the Tuesday night was before that was great, so...
I walked 12 miles, but after a mile, my ankle stops hurting, but my ankle, when I get home, I know my like, I'll be completely like, crippled for like a week. Yeah, but then I don't want to go up that hill, because then I'll push my ankle even more. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah.
I'm not trying to prove that I can survive in the wilderness. I'm not trying to beat nature. It's what I feel like doing at that moment. I sleep in my tent or my tarp, in a bivy bag, or a B&B if I want to go fancy. Tonight, after a day of pissing with rain, it's a spa hotel. But if I'm feeling good, I'll wild camp in a ditch by a dual carriageway. We're all rushing about. You can get from one side of the world to the other in 24 hours. Sometimes it's good to look at the ground in front of you. Notice the crack in the pavement, the texture of the wall, the scrawl of graffiti. The next step, rather than the next thrill.